You know, there are so many variations of the drop shot rig that it can be almost baffling. Actually, it is baffling. But the problem is they're not all created equal. Take, for instance, the crappy pickerel rig. This has proven itself in time over and over again. But with all that hardware there, you're losing so much sensitivity. Now, better than that, a local company to Michigan is the Perch Pounder by White River Tackle. What they've done is they've been able to eliminate all that hardware and actually take their leads and T-tie them right to the main leader. And on top of that, they have dressed their hooks with a piece of mylar, much like the sabiki rigs down south, catching bait fish in salt water. By the way, these work excellent here in the Great Lakes if you run out of bait fishing for perch. So if you're down south, grab yourself, bring some home. You'll get a lot of local guys who will tie up their own and sell them in local bait stores, such as this perch rig here. This one just happens to have very small blades and some beads. But again, there's a lot of hardware there robbing you of sensitivity. You are not going to get any more sensitive than actually having something tied directly to your leader through a polymer knot or a T-knot. But I prefer to have a little bit of a lead for finicky fish so that they can inhale that without feeling any tension from me or my rod. Also, you can, if you're not knot savvy, you can also buy specialty hooks. This one's got a little crane swivel, which the hook is attached to with an eye on the top and the bottom, where you can tie your lines up to, and that makes things a little more simpler. It also keeps the hook in the proper position, pointing upward. So when I'm perch fishing here, I like to use 6 pound fluorocarbon, 100% fluorocarbon. I'm gonna show you the knot that I use. So I'll take my leader material and I'll make a loop. Come on. I'll take these two pieces up here and I'll twist them at least 4 times. 6 is better, but at least 4 times. And then you're gonna pull the main lead through. I don't know if this is gonna cinch nicely because it's not floral, but don't forget to wet your knot before you pull it tight. There we go. So you got the idea, right? There it is. This is gonna go to my rod, and this is gonna have my weight on it. So I've got this hoop here. Now, you could take that end and feed it through the eye and then around the hook and pull it tight. But like I said, I don't like that idea, but I do like having this loop, and I just cut right there. And now I've got my lead, and I tie my hook right to this lead. It's very sensitive, and the hooks that I use, I prefer the Gamagatsu No. 2 or No. 4 octopus hooks. These work fantastic for the plastics that I use.